Hey guys, this is the instructional video for Howie's Owie game. This is produced by Learning Resources, and this is a favorite of a lot of my preschoolers. This is a very simple game. It's just a basic folding board. The board is magnetic and dry erase, and it comes with these little band-aids. It's got a couple different sizes and a variety of colors. I use this primarily to target body parts. I do have some kids that are working on learning how to request, and they just like sticking things on. So I will have them ask for more, please, or whatever their requesting behavior they're working on. But primarily I use it for body parts. So what I do, I have 10 that I consider kind of that base vocabulary that kids really need to know when it comes to body parts. Those are head, eyes, nose, mouth, ears, belly, arm, hand, leg, and foot. Those are the 10 that I really want my kids to be able to know if we're working on body parts. I do expand that once they know those so that they have a broader range of the vocabulary that they know for the body. Things like chin and elbow, knees, things that are really handy for kids to be able to say. But the 10 that you'll see in the video are those 10 base that I named. So when we are learning new vocabulary, there's two aspects of vocabulary. There's receptive and expressive. Receptive is a fancy word meaning, what's the kid know? What do they understand? What are they receiving from others' words? And that is always step number one. Expressive means, are they able to name the vocabulary? Can they tell me that this is a belly? But we always want to start with receptive, because if we don't understand a word, we're not going to use it. Think back to when you were learning a language in high school. I'm assuming we all had to do that. If you didn't know what a word meant, there was no reason to use it because it had no functional value for you. Same with our kids. If they don't know what a word means, they are not going to use it in a way that's meaningful. Now, they might sing songs that have the word in it, and that's a great place to start, but they're not going to use it to tell you, "Mommy, my belly hurts," if they don't understand what belly means. So receptively in the video, what you'll see me doing is I sing a little song that I just randomly came up with one day when I was trying to engage a kid who was very not interested in this game. I just started singing a little song, and he was immediately captivated by the music. And so I've been singing that with all of my kids now, and they just love it. There are so many more that have grown to love this game and will actually request it independently as like a reward. So the song goes like this. Howie's got an owie, an owie, an owie. Howie's got an owie on his nose. And then after I say nose, I put the band-aid there on his nose. When I'm working on this in one-on-one direct therapy, I don't put the band-aid on. I will hand it to the child and see if they can find it. If they cannot find it, I usually will point to the body part on myself. And for a lot of kids, that's all the prompt they need to be able to go, oh, no, it's okay. And they find it there. If they're just sticking it randomly, I'll take their hand and go, okay, let's put it on his nose and help them get it in the right place. And then I always make sure that I turn around and go, okay, where's your nose? And see if they can find it on themselves so that they know that that vocabulary doesn't just apply to Howie, that it also applies to themselves. So that's receptive, or being able to know what the words mean. The next is expressive, or being able to name them. And with that, that's where I pull out the dry erase marker. Howie's got an owie, an owie, an owie. Howie's got an owie on his. And then I wait and I see if they will fill it in. If they fill it in, good job, here's a band-aid. Put it on his nose. And then they stick it on there. Yay, we did it. We made his nose feel better. When you're doing this on the video, I will pause for a couple seconds, and sometimes kids will just go ahead and fill that in. A lot of times with videos, we're not used to actually interacting with them. We're just used to watching videos. So what you might need to do if you want your child to actually fill in the word is you might have to physically pause the video to prompt them to say what it is. And then once they say what it is, good job, and then hit play again and keep rolling. So you might need to kind of cue them that way. that they're supposed to say something and interact with this video. So what you can also do is you can also use peer modeling. If you have a sibling or another family member or even yourself, you can kind of take turns on the different body parts. So like maybe on the first one, you take a turn and you fill it in. And then on the next one, you see if they can fill it in and just keep going like that. If you're doing something like this at home, I mean, this is something really easy that you can kind of carry over to working with your child. Like, say you're playing pretend doctor and you've got the little pretend band-aids and you're talking about, oh, little Susie's got an owie, and you're singing, Howie's got an owie, or not Howie, Susie. Susie's got an owie, an owie, an owie. Susie's got an owie on her. And then you can tap the nose and say, nose, and have them put the little play band-aid on. So you can carry that over pretty easily. If you are doing that, start with a body part that you know they know. So say your little one knows eyes, and they name eyes, they point to baby dolls and say eyes, they point to your eyes and say eyes. Start with those, because that's gonna help set the pattern for what you're doing. So they're gonna start recognizing, oh, I'm supposed to fill in the name of this when you point to it or when you tap on it. And so that kind of helps build that comprehension. Which plays into the expression. If they don't understand it, they're not going to express it. So that is how we play Howie's Owie. A lot of times I will build other vocabulary in. You might see me talk about big band-aids and little band-aids. I do that a lot with following directions, especially if I have a child who's working on more complex directions. Say we've got two different color band-aids up here. When we're cleaning up, I will build in some following direction and listening skills by saying, okay, I need you to find the big green Band-Aid. And so then, okay, they have to process green, okay, but there's two green, then they have to process big, okay, big green Band-Aid. So, of course, those sorts of things are difficult to do through video, so unfortunately I won't be able to do that because that's more interactive with the child themselves. But that's things you can do at home. You can build directions like that. Say you're doing magnets on the board. Okay, can you find a yellow magnet? Can you find a little green magnet? Depending on what you have, those are things you can do. So, but this is Howie's Owie. I hope that you enjoy the videos, and I really hope that this all goes away soon and I get to see you in a few weeks. Bye guys, I will see you later.